It's me, that is Alex. Let's play the mind, shall we? Want to hear what the four basic tastes sound like? Here they are. The excerpts you just heard come from a study where a computer algorithm took care of writing the music. Four different sounding compositions were created and then played back to human subjects. Their job was to label each one of the compositions by using only one of the four basic tastes, and the result was that across different people, the same taste labels were chosen to describe the same compositions. One concern with this study was that the people had to use words for the tastes instead of experiencing the actual tastes through food samples, for instance, by eating a salty chip and then associating one of the compositions accordingly. This means that it just might be possible that the sound of the taste words had an influence on the results. Just think of how the word sweet flows out in one continuous sound as opposed to the word bitter, which has percussive elements. How about getting rid of words and using chocolate instead? A more recent study took care of eliminating the vocabulary bias by giving the subjects four different chocolate samples, each one containing a different tasting ganache filling. The conclusion was that the musical characteristics previously linked to the four basic tastes remained the same, thus being confirmed. The association people make between sound and taste isn't a recent one. Just think of the lyrics to the song Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound, or the 1883 pamphlet called The Bitter Cry of Outcast London. Even composer Hector Berlioz describes the oboe as having a petite voix aigre douce. And where does umami fit in all this? The human tongue is covered with approximately 5,000 taste buds, each one containing about 100 or so taste receptor cells. These cells are responsible for perceiving sweetness, saltiness, sourness, and bitterness, but there's also a fifth taste called umami. It was first studied in 1908 by Japanese chemist Kikunae Ikeda, and the term itself derives from the word umai, meaning delicious or savory. It's a bit difficult to describe how the tongue perceives umami, but it's the main difference between tasting beef stock instead of salt water while pinching your nose. Given that it's so tricky to isolate this fifth taste from the four other ones, no study has yet focused on which sound it may be associated with. Colors and tastes, on the other hand, have a more obvious association than sounds and tastes. The visual cues coming from the food you're about to eat give information about its nutritional content. And when you keep the same food but change its presentation, the mind gets tricked in weird ways. Alex from Technicality describes how modifying the presentation of everyday food can make it seem to be of better quality, and Brooke from The Psych Show explains how shaping brownies to make them look like poo can really, really put you off. There's a hypothesis that color vision became linked to taste perception throughout the evolution of the human species. Fruits, for instance, acquire specific color hues as they ripen. They start off green and sour, they turn red and sweet, and end up black and bitter. As for the evolutionary purpose of the link between sound and taste, it hasn't received a satisfactory explanation yet. One hypothesis is that the sounds we produce as a child while eating get encoded in our brains. For instance, when you make a yummy sound when eating something sweet, as opposed to eating something disgusting and producing a sound coming from deep within your guts. It's a challenge to receive funding for research in either music or gastronomy, but the payoff is that we're starting to uncover mysteries of the brain long unexplained, and this can be put to good use. Since we've confirmed the link between sound and taste, maybe sound designers in the future will design soundtracks that will either stimulate people's appetite or suppress it. Hashtag diet music. Cheers to that. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Subscribe to Play the Mind for more content like this coming up, and also take a moment to share this video around you, because the point of this channel isn't only to teach you cool stuff, but it's also to bring people together through music and science. So spread the word, and I'll be making more videos like the one you just watched. Thanks again, and see you next time.